Welcome to yet another session on business statistics. In today's session and in the forthcoming sessions, we are going to talk about regression analysis. In the last session, we talked about correlation. We talked about correlation between bivariate data, and we talked about correlation on attributes. But by and large, we considered only two variables and how they are related. In regression analysis, we are going to understand more about the data's nature or how much the data are interrelated. We will see how Y varies with respect to X. By this, I mean whether the dependent variable Y varies at the same rate as X, like this. Or whether the dependent variable y varies much faster, or whether the dependent variable y varies at a slower rate. Now, this will give us an idea in terms of the relationship between the two variables in terms of functional relationship. Rather, it is called the functional relationship between x and y. And that will help us to predict how the dependent variable is behaving with respect to the independent variable, and it helps us in forecasting or prediction. It finds immense use in forecasting, especially in business modeling, and that will help us to make effective decision. We will see that by way of a method called method of least square, how to arrive at the regression coefficient, okay, and what exactly this regression coefficient means, and then understand by way of a couple of examples. After that, we will talk about multiple correlation and multiple regression and partial correlation. We talked about bivariate data where we talked about relationship between two variables, X and Y. In multiple correlation, we talk about the dependent variable y and the independent variable x and z are more than two variables. So what we are going to study in multiple correlation is going to see the effect or the variability or how the dependent variable y varies with respect to both independent variables or more than two variables. So you will get a correlation that is combined correlation or the combined effect of the independent variables in arriving at the regression coefficient for the variable y, that is a dependent variable. In partial correlation is the same thing, but it is slightly different. What we do is that partial correlation also, the dependent variable is 1 or the y and the independent variable is x, z and so on. Rather, there is more than 2 independent variables. But what we do in partial correlation is that we hold one independent variable at a constant level, thereby allowing or arriving at the relationship between one independent variable and the dependent variable. Suppose you have three variables, x, z as the independent variable and y as the dependent variable. What we will do is that hold z at a particular level and try to assess the correlation between x and y, or also it's possible that we will hold x at a particular level and try to arrive at the relationship between z and y or y and z. So and that is what is called partial correlation. When you do partial correlation, what you do is that you hold one independent variable or two independent variables at a particular level and try to assess the relationship or functional relationship between the one independent variable and one dependent variable. A typical example for multiple correlation could be, there are several examples we can give. Typically, the sales revenue depends on the advertisement and marketing efforts. It depends on new product introductions. It depends on the incentives that the sales executives get. So you can see there are at least three independent variables which contribute to one dependent variable. If you take another example, the crop or the yield of agriculture crop depends on the rainfall, depends on weather condition, depends on the soil condition, depends on what kind of manure you use. You see, you can see four independent variables which can contribute to one dependent variable. So these are all the situations of multiple correlation and multiple regression. Another classical example could be that today we are talking about the vaccinations or vaccines which we have for this COVID. A classical example for partial correlation is that immunogenicity, what you call as the body provoking the immune system when a vaccine is given. Now, this vaccine at what temperature with what adjuvant produces good immunogenicity in the body? I have given quite a few examples. Now, we will go through a couple of examples in the PowerPoint presentation to understand these concepts very well. Now, let us move on to understand regression analysis. We will learn in this session simple linear regression and non-linear regression, multiple linear regression, and method of least square, a method to assess the regression parameters, multiple correlation and multiple regression, partial correlation, and multicollinear. In correlation, we talked about, is there any relationship between the variables? So we establish the relationship, whether they are related or not. Now, in regression, we go a little further to understand the functional relationship. Okay, how the variables, the dependent variable depends on the independent variable. And that is what is about regression and regression analysis. If you are able to establish such functional relationship, it is of great value for decision making. So, in simple mathematical term, what we refer is that is y is a function of x, and this is what is regression. Now, let us understand regression definition, a very simple and lucid definition. The statistical technique that establishes relationship between two or more variables in a form of equation to estimate one variable given the value of other variables is called regression analysis. Regress means to fall back or to establish a relation. It depends on. These are all the terms that are referred to regression. So regression is very important in business environment, especially decision making. Establishing functional relationship between the dependent and independent variable is very useful in business modeling. Now let us understand this pictorially. You are seeing three graphs, and these are all something which we saw in our correlation also. And these are all the points, and then the line that shows is called the trend line. Now, when we study these graphs, we will understand more. In the first one, it is high positive correlation, and functional it is a regression, high rate of climb. Okay, it's climbing quite fast. It has got a high rate of climb, almost y follows that of x. In this, it is flatter. It is moderate positive correlation because the line is close to the various data points, but the climb is slower, so it's called low rate of climb. And this is typically a non-linear correlation wherein it is not following a straight line, but it follows a curve. It's high positive correlation and the functional relationship is non-linear and the climb is high rate, rather high rate of climb, and typically this is a non-linear correlation. We will now move on to understand how to establish or how to arrive at the regression coefficients.